Well, we can open it while we're rocking holidays with mocktails.
Oh.
Non-alcoholic holiday drinks. What he calls his Christmas tree.
Season's greeting.
All right, so what do we have here?
Yeah,
right, so this is juniper soda with cranberry juice, right?
I'm not so that's familiar with the juniper
soda. Yeah, yeah. This is an awesome little company called Dry Out in Seattle.
Thank you.
So just juniper soda. It's not a lot of sugar, a little bit of cranberry.
Is this rosemary made to look like that, a
that's rosemary because juniper is evergreen.
What do you say? Hey, here's to a holiday season.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Happy Friday, y'all.
Yeah. All right. Top Chef champ Richard Blaze is here with us this morning. Good morning, Richard.
Morning.
Holiday parties that are free of something that you might
want. All right. There you go. Yeah. Everybody into the pool.
Eggnog.
Yes.
Mocktails.
What is very
one,
mock.
One for Frosty there.
What are these recipes that he's going to have?
What's this?
This is morningamerica.com.
Faux eggnog. So this is half and half Sprite and cherry juice. It tastes a lot better than it sounds.
No, it's good.
It's so good.
It's like a cherry.
For the kids. It's a kid's eggnog.
Yeah,
it's a kid's eggnog.
That's like a... Yeah, like a float.
That's like a float. It's delicious. Right. Turns out it's good. Delicious. Shockingly.
Rachel, you got to put the drink down and get to work.
Okay, guys.
Here's to you, Rachel.
This is not a bad gig. All right, so the hump.
There he is, little DJ Sugar Ray, helping us count down to Christmas with our 12 Days of Cooking right now. And we're here today with our friend from Top Chef, Richard Blaze, also owner of the Spence in Atlanta. Been making fantastic mocktails all morning. What's this one?
This is a Mexican hot chocolate with whipped cream, right? Now, Mexican hot chocolate has a little cinnamon in it, so it's perfect for the holidays. Mm. And we're topping it with some ground up red hot candy. Right? So the red hots have a little bit.
Yeah.
You have that whipped cream mustache? It's good, right?
Cute look.
It's the cinnamon. So you have the red hots crushed up on
now,
there. A little spice.
That is. Now, you're going to use some Christmas candies throughout all this, and this is going to be something. Lamb chops with candy cane, but there's a little prep first.
Lamb chops with candy cane, right. So what we're going to do is, this is an English cut lamb chop, all right? So it's basically the saddle, a big, meaty lamb chop, right? Very good for the holidays. And yeah, the challenge is, you have all of this stuff laying around from the holidays. Can you actually use it, recycle it, cook with candy canes and gingerbread and Christmas tree even, or in this case, rosemary, which is kind of like Christmas tree, right? So rosemary and lamb is pretty synonymous.
Perfect.
Right?
What else you put on?
So we have some salt, we have some olive oil. All right, and we're gonna put some mint on here, some coriander. You wanna help me just throw some of that in? Some fennel seed, coriander.
Right there,
some black pepper.
Yeah.
And how long do you let this sit?
Really, I mean, this can sit for, if you have an hour, that's fine. If it's 30 minutes, that's fine. If it's overnight, that's fine too, right? Okay. So we're gonna season these.
And that's what it looks like after it's been sitting for a little while.
That's what it looks like after it's been sitting for a little while.
Got some garlic on there too, yeah.
Because those have all that marinade in it. And then a hot grill, all right? And this is great for inside, these cast iron grills. So you can cook, you know, even if it's cold outside, you can do a little grilling inside. It'll get some of that flavor from the cast iron. You know, and that's what you want. You know, you want that sound right there. Doesn't it look delicious?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Turns out it tastes delicious as well.
All right, and we're going to throw those on the grill. You want to hear that sizzle, right? Mm-hmm. That's, you know, it's cooking that way.
Now, these are pretty thick.
How long
are they going to take on that grill?
I mean, this is probably going to take like 20 minutes or so. Mm-hmm. You might want to throw them on the grill over here. You can see they're finishing up. Throw them on the grill, pop them in the oven, finish them up in the oven.
Right.
All right, so those are going to cook right there.
Okay.
And then that's the rosemary. So that's us cooking with a wreath or a Christmas tree, right? And then we're moving over to some of our more creative sides, right? So polenta, right? Polenta is great. You can see right here we have polenta, and what we've done is, very simply, where is the ash?
Yeah, what have you sprinkled on it? Because it's so good.
We have unfortunately pulverized the gingerbread.
Gingerbread?
I mean, we've pulverized. We have, right?
So
ginger's got all that flavor, so it's aromatic. Right?
So you just sprinkle it on top.
And the great thing is, you know what? This can be a stale gingerbread, man. That's okay.
I will say, he gave his life so that we could enjoy, and we thank him for it.
Absolutely, absolutely.
And then sacrifice.
Right? And then, of course, cream spinach. This is probably my favorite sort of recipe here. Cream spinach cooked with eggnog.
Love it.
Right? So eggnog has nutmeg in it. Cream spinach usually has nutmeg in it. So a great way to utilize your wreath, your Christmas tree, gingerbread man.
Good.
And then, of course, the last step right here, the candy cane. Right? The candy cane. I need some help here. Can you help me out?
Okay, yeah.
All right, here we go. We're going to shave some candy cane on top of the lamb. All right? All right, so there we go. It's like Parmesan in a nice Italian restaurant.
I guess.
All right. Lamb and mint works really well. And that's going to give it a little sweetness.
Oh, thank you. Look at that.
And a little sort of a little bit of
rosemary mint.
A little shade there.
Right?
Yeah.
And this is very local, of course. It's from the store on the corner. So it works really well.
You can get all the recipes, also the recipes for Richard's mocktails at goodmorningamerica.com on Yahoo. We're going to be right back. I need some silverware, guys.